Welcome to our YouTube channel Knowledge Academy. Today we are going to discuss about the 10 numerical problems of network theory. If you are seeing this lecture for the first time, then please go back to the playlist Get Previous Year Questions, so that from starting onwards you can see all the lectures, so you will understand the flow of the lectures. If you like the content of this lecture, then please like, share and subscribe our channel, so that you will get motivation to do more educational videos. If there is any improvement required in the making of these lectures or in the content of the lectures, then please provide feedback in the comment section, so that we will improve ourselves to make better quality of educational videos. Today we are going to discuss about the 10 numerical problems in network theory. So let's get started. Now we will see the 41 problem. This problem says that there is a source. For this source, there is a 1 ohm resistance is connected to this source. This resistor is a linear resistor, means the characteristics across the resistor is a linear, that is the VI characteristics of this resistor is a straight line which passes through origin for all time. So this source has a load line equation, that is V plus I is equal to 100, means the voltage and the current relationship across this source is V plus I is equal to 100. This is called as the load line equation of this source. So our main aim in this problem is to figure out the value of the current I. This problem is given in the GATE 2010 for 1 mark. So now we need to calculate the value of the current I. So let's get started to do this numerical. See here, we know the relationship across the resistor is V is equal to IR, because it is a linear resistor. So that way this is the linear equation across the resistor. See here, by applying the KVL around this closed path, see, I am going from lower potential to higher potential, so there is a rise in potential, so we can write plus V. See here, the current always goes from higher potential to lower potential. So there is, current is I and the resistor is R, is equal to 0. So therefore, V is equal to IR. See, both are same. This, I just wanted to show that we can write this equation by your KVL also, or whether you can directly write V is equal to IR. See, the value of the resistor is 1 ohm. If you substitute that value of the resistor in this equation, we will get V is equal to I. We got V is equal to I. This is our first equation. Already, the relation across the voltage and the current is 100. That's all. So V plus I is equal to 100. This is our second equation. This is the first equation and this is the second equation. Our aim is to figure out the value of the I. So in place of V, we substitute I. So I plus I is equal to 100. So therefore, I plus I, 2I, is equal to 100. So therefore, I is equal to 50 ampere. So finally, the value of the current through the resistor is 50 ampere. If you want to calculate the value of the voltage for this particular resistance, we can easily figure out by this equation, because V is equal to I. So the finally, for this particular resistor, if we keep across this source for a load line equation, V plus I is equal to 100, finally we will get V is equal to 50 volt and I is equal to 50 ampere. And now we will move forward to do the another question, which is 42nd. This question says that there are two parts in this question. First part says that there is a circuit in which there is a voltage source Vs, there is a current source Is, there is a resistor 2 ohm. We need to calculate the value of the current through this 2 ohm resistance when Vs is equal to 4 volt and Is is equal to 5 ampere, and we need to calculate the value of the current through this 2 ohm resistor. This is the first case. And the second case is there is another voltage source which we need to figure out so that the current in this 2 ohm resistor is twice the current which is produced in the first case. So the value of Is is same in both cases. This question is given in the GATE 2009 for 2 marks. So we need to figure out these two unknowns in these two cases. So let's get started to solve this problem. See here, we know the value of Vs, we know the value of Is. All we have to do is to figure out the value of the I. See, by using KVL, we can easily figure out this unknown parameter, which is I. See here, the current always travels from higher potential to lower potential. So therefore, make it as a positive and this one is a negative. See, by assuming a loop, KVL loop, let us draw a KVL loop in this direction, in this way. See, from minus to plus, there is a rising potential. So mark it as plus Vs. After going up to here, there is a positive and there is a negative. So I am traveling from positive to negative. It means that there is a drop in potential. So therefore, minus current is I and the resistor is 2 ohm. Therefore, is equal to 0. So Vs is equal to 2 times current I. As Vs is 4 volt, therefore 4 is equal to 2i. Therefore, I is equal to 4 divided by 2. We'll get I is equal to 2 ampere. So the finally we got the unknown parameter, which is I is equal to 2 ampere in the first case. So with this, now we'll move forward to do the second part of this question. The second part is the current through this resistor 2 ohm is I dash is equal to twice the current of the first case. We know the value of the current in the first case, which is 2 ampere. Therefore, I dash is equal to 2 times of 2 is equal to 4 ampere. So now we have to figure out what is the value of the voltage, which is Vs dash, which is a new voltage, Vs dash. Like same previous method, now we need to follow the KVL. See here, let me draw some loop here. Here, see, always current goes from higher potential to lower potential. So therefore, I mark it as positive and the downward as negative. So let me make this as a KVL loop. See, I am going from low potential to higher potential. Therefore, there is a rising voltage. Therefore, it is Vs plus Vs dash. After traveling up to here, there is a positive and there is a negative. So I am traveling from positive to negative. So therefore, there is a decreasing potential. So I have to keep it as a minus sign. So minus I dash into 2 is equal to 0. But we know I dash is equal to 4 ampere. So 4 2 is 8. So if we take the right side, therefore Vs dash is equal to 8 volt. So we figure out I is equal to 2 ampere and we figured out Vs dash is equal to 8 volt. See here, the value of voltage across this current source Is is 4 volt in the first case. The value of voltage across the current source Is is Vs dash, which is 8 volt in the second case. Okay, now we will move forward to do the another question, which is 43rd. This question says that there is a circuit in which there are resistors, there is capacitors, and there is a dependent current source. The resistors are 1 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm, 1 kilo ohm, and there is a capacitor of 100 microfarad, and there is another capacitor of 100 microfarad. The aim of this question is to figure out what is the equivalent capacitance across the input side. Means we need to figure out what will be the equivalent capacitor. Equivalent capacitance across this input side. This we need to figure out. This question is given in the GATE year 2009 for 2 marks. So let's get started to solve this numerical problem. See here, we can easily figure out what is the value of the current across any junction by KCL. So see here, at this junction there are 2 currents are coming, which is I1 is passing through dielectric, so the current will flow here also I1 and here also I1. See, there is a dependent current source. The value of this current source depends upon the current which is present in the inside, in the input loop. So therefore the value of this current in this branch is 49 I1. So therefore here also 49 I1. So it goes us like this, it comes to straight line and finally it comes across this junction. So across this junction or this node, there are 2 currents which are coming, which are I1 and the another one is 49 I1. So by KCL, sum of input currents is equal to sum of output current. Therefore I1 plus 49 I1 is equal to 50 I1. So therefore in this branch, in this capacitor, therefore 50 I1 is the current which flows in this capacitor. So now by KCL, see, these two resistors are connected in series. Therefore 1 kilo ohm and 1 kilo ohm will become 2 kilo ohm. So in place of, so I am just short circuiting this one. So therefore this will become 2 kilo ohm. So now I am writing KVL in this loop. I am writing KVL in this loop. So the current always goes from higher potential to lower potential. So make this positive and the negative. See, in this side also, the current goes from higher potential to lower potential. See here, by KVL, I am growing from lower potential to higher potential. Therefore, plus VIN. See here, the current goes from higher potential to lower potential. So I am traveling from plus to minus. So there is a drop. So minus 2 kilo into I1. 2 kilo into I1. 2 kilo ohm into I1. So here see, again there is a drop in potential. So that's why I have taken it as a minus symbol. So here the current is 50 I1 and the capacitor is 100 microfarad. So let me take it as a C. Let me consider it is a C value. So therefore we know which is current is 50 I1 and the capacitor reactance is minus JXC. Capacitor, the value of the inductor is the value of the inductor plus JXL. The reactance of the capacitor is minus JXC. So there are no inductors, only capacitors are there. So I am including it as a minus JXC in this equation. All you are trying to do is to figure out the value of the equivalent capacitors across the input side. So therefore net KVL is equal to 0. The sum of potential drops across a closed loop is equal to 0. See here, it is plus VIN is equal to, I am taking this term and this term to the right side. So it will become 2 kilo into I1 plus 50 I1 into minus JXC. So in these two terms, I1 is the common. So I1, which is 2 kilo means 2000. 2000 plus 50. So plus into minus, it will become minus, right? So minus J, 50 to XC into J. I have taken J to the right side. So X will come inside. So let me write it another way, fashion. So VIN by I1. Is equal to 2000 minus J50XC. So from the input side, the circuit will be equivalent to, the whole circuit will be equivalent to just one thing. See it here, there is a plus minus VIN and the current is I1. So therefore current is I1 traveling, and see here there is a 2000 ohm minus J XC minus J into 50 times XC. So therefore, this will become 2 kilo ohm. 2 kilo ohm means 2000 ohm, and there is a capacitor. There is a capacitor with a reactance of 50 XC. So therefore, there is a capacitor with a reactance of minus J 50 XC. But we need to figure out the value of the C equivalent. See here. So therefore, XC net is equal to input side rate. Input rate means C equivalent is equal to 50 times XC. Simply, what I am trying to say is minus J 50 into XC can be written as minus J XC equivalent. So therefore, XC equivalent is equal to 50 times of XC. 50 times of XC. So XC equivalent is equal to 1 by omega C equivalent is equal to 50 times of XC is equal to 1 by omega C, where C is the value of C is 100 microfarad. So therefore, omega will be cancelled. So we need to figure out C equivalent is equal to C by 50. So value of C is 100 microfarad and divided by 50, you will get 2 microfarad. Therefore, the value of the C equivalent is equal to 2 microfarad. This is a required solution which we have figured out after solving the previous problem. Now we will move forward to do the another problem, which is 44th problem. In this problem, there is a one lamp which has a rating of 100 watt for 220 volt. So means this bulb has a rating of 100 watts for 220 volt. Means if we supply it to 220 volt, then the bulb will dissipate a power of 100 watt. If we supply less than this 220 volt, then the bulb will dissipate less than the 100 watt rating. Suppose if we exceed the voltage of more than 220, then the bulb may damage. Means it may work up to some voltage, but if we exceed more than that limit also, this bulb will get damaged. Similarly, in this circuit, there is a 220 volt supply. Each lamp has a rating of 200 watt for 220 volt. Means in this circuit, each bulb has a rating of 200 watt for 220 volt. So the aim of this question is to figure out when the power consumed by this bulb, individual bulb, is equal to the power consumed by the net. The power consumed by this net circuit is equal. So this is given in the question. So we need to figure out how many these identical bulbs of 200 watt for 220 volt must be kept in this circuit. So we need to figure out how many these bulbs we must keep in this circuit. So let me consider it as n number of bulbs which has a rating of 200 watt for 220 volt. This we need to figure out in this problem. This problem is given in the GATE 2009 for 1 mark. So now let's figure out. See, for this bulb we have given it rated supply means 220 volt. So therefore, this bulb will dissipate a power of 100 watt because we are giving rated voltage. So therefore, the bulb will dissipate the rated voltage. Therefore, P1 is equal to 100 watt. So now we need to figure out the value of P2. P2 means for this identical bulbs of rating of 200 watt for 220 volt, we need to figure out how much is the net power consumed by these lamps. So let me consider only single bulb. For this single bulb, I will make it as a notation of 1. 1 means this first bulb. See here, in this bulb, for this bulb there is a reading of 200 watt with 220 voltage rating. So here given for this first bulb, one means this one first starting bulb, it has a rating of 200 watt for 220 volt. So I need to figure out the value of the resistance. We know the wattage, we know the voltage, means P is equal to V square by R. R is the resistance of the first bulb. So P means 200, V means 220 whole square by R. So by calculation we will get R is equal to the value of the resistance R of the first bulb is 242 ohm. So we got the value of the resistor is 242 ohm. So therefore if we connect n number of bulbs, each bulb has same voltage rating and same voltage loading, so therefore each bulb has a same resistance which is 242 ohm. As these bulbs are connected in series connection, therefore the net resistance is equal to sum of their individual resistance. So each resistance, each bulb has a resistance of 242. If there are n identical bulbs, therefore the net resistance is equal to n times of the individual resistor. So therefore R equivalent is equal to n times R. So therefore n times R means R is equal to 242. Therefore 242 times of n. So now this whole circuit will become equivalent to, this whole circuit will become equivalent to, there is a voltage of 220 volt and there is a resistor of 242 n. So now we need to calculate how much is the power consumed by this resistor. So therefore we know the value of P is equal to, which is P2, we already given notation, that is P2. P2 means the total power which is consumed by this circuit, by this second circuit. Therefore P2 is equal to V square by R equivalent. V is 220. Therefore 220 whole square by R equivalent is 242 times of N. Therefore this is P2. As already given the question, P1 is equal to P2. We figure out value of P1, which is 100 watt. Therefore P2 we calculated from this equation. So we need to equate this 100 watt and 220 whole square by 242 n. So I am writing the equation, 100 is equal to 220 whole square by 242 n. Therefore in this equation there is only one unknown, which is n. So if we do the calculation, n is equal to 2, sorry, n is equal to 2, means we need to connect only two identical 200 watt for 220 volt rating, then only this circuit will consume a power which is equivalent to 100 watt. I am saying it again, in this circuit we need to connect two identical bulbs of rating 200 watt for 220 volt, then only the circuit consumes a power which is equivalent to the power consumed by this circuit. After solving the previous problem, now let's move forward to do the other question, which is 45th. This question says that there is a bridge which has an impedance of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4 and there is another impedance of Z5 which connects the first branch and the second branch. These are the values of Z1 1 kilo ohm, Z2 1 kilo ohm, Z3 1 kilo ohm, Z4 1 kilo ohm and Z5 2 kilo ohm. We need to figure out the value of the current in this Z5, and this question is given the gate 2009 year for the 1 mark. So we need, our aim in this problem is to figure out the value of the current I which going through the Z5 impedance. That is our main agenda. Actually this bridge is a Wheatstone bridge, and this bridge is balanced only when the condition is the bridge is balanced. Means the bridge is balanced means the current in the branch Z5, which connects this series, which this the Z5 connects the branch this one and the other branch this one down part. So the balanced condition, the balanced condition is, this is a condition which means Z1, the ratio of the product of the opposite impedances are equal. The balanced condition is the product of the opposite impedances are equal. Means Z1 opposite is Z4 and Z2 opposite is Z3. So product Z1 into Z4 is equal to Z2 into Z3. If this condition is satisfied, then the current in the branch Z5 is zero. Means there is no current passes through the impedance Z5. Therefore, if you see this condition is satisfied by these values, Z1 is 1 and Z4 is also 1. So therefore 1 into 1 is equal to Z2 is 1 and Z3 is also 1. So this condition for 1 into 1 is equal to 1 into 1. Therefore 1 is equal to 1. So therefore the condition is satisfied by these values. Therefore the current in the branch Z5 is 0. Therefore, I is equal to 0. This is a balanced Wheatstone bridge. So, whenever this condition is satisfied, the current in this branch is 0. It means there is no need to keep this one. So, we can eliminate this one. So, the current is, let me take it as an I1 and this as an I2. So, the current I1 travels the same in Z1 and is also same in Z2. Therefore, I2, the current is same in Z3 impedance and also same in the Z4. So, therefore, the input current is sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. So, there is only one branch which is incoming. So, therefore, the current will become I1 plus I2. Similarly, as the current is flowing, as there is the current flows the same in this direction, therefore the current in this branch is also equal to I1 plus I2. So finally, when the circuit is balanced condition, the product of the opposite impedances are equal. Therefore, the current in the branch which connecting the Z1, Z2 and Z3, Z4, this branch, the current through this is zero. This is the required solution. After solving the previous problem, now let's move forward to do the other question, which is 46th. In this question, there is a voltage source, DC voltage source of 5 volt, and there are two resistors of identical value which are 1 ohm. Similarly, there is another circuit in this one, there is a 1 ohm and 3 ohm, and there is a dependent voltage source of 4 times of VAB, where VAB is the voltage difference across these two nodes, A and B. The aim of this question is to figure out the value of the current in this branch. I is equal to, we need to figure out. And this question is given in the year 2008 for 2 marks. All we need, the main aim of this problem is to find the value of the current I. See here, now let's go and solve this problem. See here, let me assume there is a current I1. Let me assume there is a current I1 which is flowing in this direction. See, as the current is flowing in this direction, so therefore it will flow in this direction always in this circle, like in this circle, right? So therefore in this branch is also there is a current of 1 ampere. Similarly, as a current comes up to here and goes in this direction, so here also the current is I1. Similarly, in this branch, the given direction of current is I. So the current is go up to here, travels here, as there is only one branch and there are no other branches at this junction, therefore the current also in this branch is also equal to I. Similarly, the current travels up to this branch, as there is no other branches except this branch, so whatever the current coming up to this branch will flow in this branch also. So now let me assume there is a wire. See, as the current is I1 up to here, let me consider the current in this branch is somewhat I2. Let me assume the current in this branch is I2. So now write the KCL across this junction. So the incoming currents are I1 and the outgoing currents are I1 and I2. So the sum of incoming currents is equal to sum of outgoing currents. So therefore I1 is equal to I1 plus I2. So I1, if I1 comes goes to this side, so I1 minus I1 is equal to 0. Therefore I2 is equal to 0 ampere. So the I2 is 0 ampere. Similarly, if you write a KCL across this junction, the current incoming is I1 and another current incoming is I2 and the outgoing current is I. So therefore, sum of incoming currents are I1 and I2 and the outgoing current is I. So therefore, the sum of incoming currents are I1 plus I2 is equal to I. So in both sides, the common term is I. So therefore, I2 is equal to 0. So what I am trying to say is, the value of current in this branch is 0. Therefore, I2 is equal to 0 means if we disconnect this wire is imaginary wire or we are just physically connecting. If we connect this wire or if we remove this wire, there is no change in the circuit values. Means if we connect any physical wire across these both circuits or if we disconnect the wire, there is no change in the parameters of this circuit and there is no change in the parameters of this circuit because I2 is 0. So let me assume there is a wire physically I am connecting so that there is no change in circuit parameters. So why can't we connect a wire? So I connected a wire across this both circuit and I am assuming this has a potential of 0 volt. Means as a reference node I am taking this one. See, now let me find some values which are very required to figure out the value of the exact value of the current I. See, up to now I just figure out if we connect or if we disconnect, there is no change in the value of the current in this branch, in this circuit and also in this circuit. So now let's actually find the value of the current I. See here, this circuit is a series connection, right? 1 ohm and 1 ohm, because the same current is flowing in this both resistor. So by voltage division, this node is denoted by A. So let me write this as a voltage VA. Let me make it as a VA. So therefore, by voltage division rule, VA is equal to 5 volt into 1 ohm by 1 plus 1. So 1 plus 1. Therefore 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5 volt. So VA is equal to 2.5 volt. VA is equal to 2.5 volt. Similarly, now write the KVL in this loop. I am writing the KVL in this loop. Now I am writing the KVL in this loop. In this loop, as I am going from lower potential to higher potential, there is a rising voltage. So therefore, I am making it as a plus 4 VAB. See, always current travels from higher potential to lower potential. So I will make it as a positive and this as a negative. Similarly, the current goes from higher potential to lower potential. So I make it as a positive and another is negative. Up to here I crossed. So now I am going from higher potential to lower potential. So there is a decreasing voltage. Resistor is 3 ohm and the current is I. Similarly, from here to here I am walking. So there is a decreasing potential from positive to negative. There is a drop in potential, right? So minus 1 into I is equal to 0. Right? So therefore, 4 VAB is equal to minus 3 I and minus I. It will become minus 4 I. If I shift to the right side, it will become 4 times of I. Therefore, 4 cancel. Therefore, VAB is equal to I. So VAB is equal to I. See here, if VAB is equal to I, let me mark this as a voltage VB. Means there is a node there is a node B notation. That's why I am marking this voltage across this 1 ohm resistor as VB. So this circuit is a series circuit, right? So VB, I need to calculate the value of the voltage VB. So VB is equal to current and current into resistor. The current is I and the resistor is 1 ohm. So I into 1. So therefore VB is equal to I, right? Now I am writing the another KVL, or no need to write KVL also directly. So VAB means what? This is VA, or I will write the KVL. See here, I am writing KVL in this direction, right? In this way I am writing a KVL. See, I am going from minus to positive, there is a rising potential, right? So plus VA, I travel up to this direction. Now there is a drop potential from plus to minus, so therefore minus VAB. And from here to here, I am going from positive to negative, so there is a decrease in potential, so minus VB is equal to 0, because I have traveled a closed loop. So therefore plus VA minus VAB minus VB is equal to 0. See, VA already we know, this 2.5. VA is already we know, minus plus 2.5. So VAB is equal to I, right? VAB is equal to I. So therefore VAB is equal to I. And we already got VB is equal to I. So VB is also equal to I. So therefore 2.5 is equal to 2I. So we need to figure out the value of I. So I is equal to 2.5 divided by 2. So it will become 1.25 ampere. So this is our final result which we got. So after solving the previous question, now we will move forward to solve the other question, which is 47th. This question says that there is a current source of 1 ampere. The voltage across this current source is V1, and there is a resistance of 2 ohm, and there is another ideal voltage source of 5 volt. This question is given in the GATE 2008 year for 2 marks. The aim of this question is to figure out the value of the voltage V1. Means, what is the voltage across this current source that we need to figure out for this circuit? As we know that the current in the current source is constant, but the value of the voltage across the current source can vary. No matter what is the voltage across the current source, the value of the current in the current source is always constant. It means V1 can be anything, whether it can be positive, whether it can be negative, or whether it can be zero in a circuit. But the value of the current in the current source is always constant, and the direction is also constant. If it is given in upward, the value of, suppose in this circuit it is given 1 ampere, means no matter wherever this source is connected, always the direction goes in this direction from down to up. In this circuit, there is a current source of 1 ampere, and the direction is also given from down to up. So here also the current is 1 ampere, means the whole circuit has a current of 1 ampere. So it travels up to here, and there is no other branch to go outside, so therefore it comes downward and also goes to left side. So therefore whole circuit has a current of 1 ampere, means 1 ampere in this way also, in this branch also, and 1 ampere in this branch, and also here also 1 ampere. So the whole circuit has a current of 1 ampere. As we know, the current travels from higher potential to lower potential. So now let us write the KVL in this loop. So from here, in this I am going from negative to positive, so therefore there is a rising voltage, so therefore plus V1. From here positive to negative, yes, there is a decrease in potential, so therefore minus current is, resistor is 2 and the current is 1 ampere, right? From here minus to plus, there is a rising potential, so therefore it is plus 5, and there is no other resistance in this branch, so therefore the whole KVL loop is finished. So therefore, by KVL, the net algebraic sum of voltages in a closed loop is equal to 0. So therefore V1 minus 2 plus 5 is equal to 0. So therefore V1 is equal to minus 3. This is the required solution of this problem. So therefore V1 is equal to minus 3 volt. So finally, again I am telling you that the current source, the direction of the current source in the branch, if it is down to up, it will be always in the same. But the voltage can be anything, whether it can be zero, whether it can be positive, whether it can be negative, depending upon the circuit it is connected. But the value of the current is always constant, which is 1 ampere in the circuit. After solving the previous problem, now let's move forward to do the another question, which is 48th question. This question says that there is a Thevenin voltage of 3.71 at an angle of minus 15.9 degrees. And there is a Thevenin impedance of 2.38 minus 0.667. So the aim of this question is to figure out the minimum components required to construct the ZTH. Means the minimum components required to construct ZTH. So we need to figure out minimum components. This question is given in the GATE 2018 year for 1 mark. See here. ZTH is equal to, they are given 2.38 minus J 0.667, means it has a resistor. 2.38 means, as there is no J term in this 2.38, it means it is a resistor. So resistor is R. R is equal to 2.38 ohm. So here minus J 0.667. see, for capacitor we used to denote like minus jXc. For an inductor, we used to denote it as plus jXl. See here there is a negative, here it is a positive sign, here it is negative sign. So there are two cases which are possible to make this minus J 0.667 from these two components. The first case is case 1. Case 1 is only capacitor which has a reactance XC, which has a XC is equal to 0.667 ohms. Or case 2, you take series combination of inductor and capacitor. Means you take a series combination of inductor and a capacitor. This is plus jXl and minus jXc. So therefore the net reactance is equal to J common, so therefore XL minus XC. But we need a negative term. So therefore if XL is greater than XC, the whole combination becomes a positive sign. But we need a negative sign. This is possible only when XC is greater than XL. So therefore XC greater than XL, then only the whole combination is a negative. So by using these two combinations also, it is possible to get a minus J 0.667, or simply by using a capacitor, single capacitor also, we can get a value of minus J 0.667. So I am taking this as a series combination of inductor and capacitor. So suppose if I take a resistor of 2.38 ohm, if I take a capacitor, so there are two terms, resistor and capacitor, therefore two components. In another case, the resistor or inductor and capacitor, so the resistor is one component, inductor is another, and the capacitor is another. So therefore 1, 2, 3. So therefore R, L, C is equal to three components. So finally, to construct ZTH, there are two ways. Whether we can take RC or a combination of R, L, C, which gives three components. In the previous one, two components. But we need to find out the minimum components required to construct ZTH. So out of two and three, the minimum is two. So therefore, the minimum only two components are required to construct ZTH. Therefore, the minimum components is two, After solving the previous problem, now let's move forward to do the other problem, which is 49th. In this problem, they given that there is a practical voltage source. The practical voltage source has a voltage of 3 volt and internal resistance of 2 ohm. And for this circuit, for this practical voltage source, we have connected a non-linear load which has a voltage of VNL, and the current passing through this non-linear load is INL. So in this question, they have given the relationship between non-linear load voltage and non-linear load current is VNL is equal to INL square. So the main aim of this question is to figure out how much is the power consumed by this non-linear load. Power consumed by a non-linear load, we need to figure out in this question. This question is given in the GATE 2007 for 2 marks. So let us do it. Let us solve this problem. See here, we have to write a KVL equation. We have to write a KVL equation. See, the current always goes from higher potential to lower potential, right? The current is going in this direction, right? It is given in the circuit itself. So as the current is going from down to up, so let me consider this as a positive and this is a negative, because current always goes from higher potential to lower potential. So buried in the KVL equation in this loop, as I am going from minus to plus, so there is a rising potential, plus 3. Again, from here, positive to negative, so there is a drop in potential, which is minus. So the current is INL and the resistor is 2. So 2 into INL. And after coming up to this part, up to here, this point, see here I am traveling from positive to negative, so there is again drop in potential. So minus VNL is equal to 0. But if you see, VNL is already given in the question as INL square. So therefore, plus 3 minus 2 INL minus INL square. INL square is equal to 0. Let me bring all these terms to the right side. So it will become INL square plus 2 INL minus 3 is equal to 0, right? It is a quadratic equation. Means after solving this equation, you will get two roots. So if you solve this equation, you will get INL is equal to minus 3 comma 1. So we need to figure out which one is actually correct for this circuit. See, before I figure out which one is correct, let me tell you a small concept. See here, there is a load. This is L means load. Suppose, okay, I will replace the L by some element E. Let me consider this as the element E. Suppose this is the voltage notation across this element, and if the current is going from higher potential to lower potential across this element, then this element is going to absorb energy. This element is going to absorb energy or absorb power. This element is going to absorb power. Suppose for the same element, if I consider it as a plus and minus V, and if the current is going from minus to plus, means the current is going from negative to positive, so then this element is going to deliver power. Means this element is going to deliver power or energy. See, one thing I am going to say is, always the linear loads or non-linear loads are always going to absorb the power or energy in any circuit condition. But an active element can deliver energy or absorb energy based on circuit condition. I will repeat what I said earlier. All the linear loads or non-linear loads always absorb the energy or power. But an active element can absorb energy or deliver energy based on the circuit conditions. See here, this is a non-linear load. So this element has to absorb the energy. Means the current has to travel from positive potential to negative potential. See here, this condition is satisfied with 1 ampere because it is a positive sign, right? Positive sign means whatever the direction we assumed in the question is correct. So therefore this is correct. Let us check this one, -3. Minus sign, right? Minus means negative. Negative means the direction of the current has to be reverse. Means what is trying to say is -3 means now the direction of current is not in this direction, it is in this direction, reverse. So the current is going from negative to positive. Means this is going to deliver energy. But that is not the case, right? The element has to absorb the energy. So that's why the answer which is -3 is the wrong answer. Which is -2 because this indicates that the element, the non-linear load is, it tells that the non-linear load is delivering energy. But this is not the right. So the positive sign indicates that the non-linear load is absorbing the energy. So therefore this is correct and this is wrong. So now we got INL is equal to 1 ampere, right? INL is equal to 1 ampere. See here, we need to figure out the amount of power absorbed by this non-linear load, right? See, the suppose P by 3 volt is equal to P by 2 ohm plus P of non-linear load. Means by Telegen's theorem, the amount of power delivered is equal to the amount of power absorbed. The power delivered is only by 3 volt because the current is traveling from negative to positive. So negative to positive means this element is going to deliver the power. See here, in this element, the current is traveling from positive to negative, means positive to negative. So therefore this element is going to absorb the power. This is going to deliver, this is going to absorb. And similarly, in this non-linear load also, the current is going from positive to negative. So therefore, this element is also going to absorb the power. So the amount of power delivered is equal to amount of power absorbed. So in this question, only one element is going to deliver power and the remaining two elements are going to absorb the power. See here, power delivered by the 3 volt is equal to the voltage and the current. Voltage is 3 and the current is INL. INL is 1. So therefore 3 into 1 is equal to 3. Is equal to power by the power absorbed by the 2 ohm is equal to current is how much here? Current is 1 ampere, right? INL is 1. So I square R. I square means 1 square into R is 2. So 1 square into 2 is equal to 2. Plus we need to figure out the amount of power absorbed by this non-linear load. So therefore, after simplification, 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So therefore, finally we got power absorbed by the non-linear load is equal to 1 watt. So in this question, the main aim is to figure out the amount of power absorbed by the non-linear load, which is 1 watt. So finally we calculated it. Okay, now after solving the previous question, now let's move forward to figure out the solution of the next problem. This is a very most beautiful problem. So let us focus more to get the solution of this type of problems. See here, there are two AC sources which have a magnitude of V and an angle of 0 volt. Both are identical AC voltage sources. See here, there is a resistor and there is a capacitor. The resistor values are and the capacitor values is minus JXC. See here, there are two points x comma y. These are open circuit. There is no connection between x and y physically. Means there is an open circuit and the voltage difference is V by x. Means the voltage y, the node voltage y is more positive than the node voltage x, which is already given in the question. The main aim of this question is to figure out the locus of V by x when R is equal to 0 to infinity. Means we need to find the locus of V by X when there is a variation of resistance from 0 to infinity. And this question is given in the GATE 2007 for 2 marks. So here, see here, let me consider the direction of current is like this. So in this branch is also the current is I. As this branch is open circuit, the current in this branch is 0 ampere, right? current in this branch is 0 ampere. So whatever the current coming has to flow in this branch, because the current in this branch is 0. So therefore, in this branch is also current high. Similarly, the current in this branch is also I. So whatever the current flows in this branch has to flow in this voltage source I. Similarly, this branch is open circuit, so whatever the current in this branch is 0 ampere, because this is open circuit. So therefore, the current, whatever the current in this branch has to go into this branch, right? So therefore, the whole circuit is a series connected, and the current in this branch is 0 because it is open circuit, what I am trying to say. That is what I am trying to say. See here, now I am going to write a KVL across this loop. See here, outer loop. I am going to write a KVL in this outside loop from down, and it has to go down this direction, and finally I am to come in this direction. See here, I am going from negative to positive, right? So there is a rising potential, V angle 0. And similarly, after here, I am traveling from negative to positive. So there is a rising potential, 0 to angle 0. See here, the current has to travel from higher potential to lower potential, right? So from positive to negative, therefore there is a decreasing potential, so minus Ra. Similarly, the current has traveled from positive to negative, means higher potential to lower potential. So therefore there is a decreasing potential. So therefore minus current I, reactance is minus J X is equal to 0, right? V angle 0 plus V angle 0 is called 2V angle 0. So therefore angle 0, no need to write, because it is a real number, right? So minus, here I am taking common is I. So I. So R is a term. As I am taking minus outside, therefore this minus will be coming outside, like minus J XE is equal to 0, right? Now I need the expression for the current I. So therefore current I is equal to 2V by R minus J XE. So this is the expression for the current I. But we need the expression for the voltage V by X. That can be get only if I write the KVL in this loop. Now I am going to write the KVL in this smaller loop. See here, I am writing here. Listen carefully. This is going to be algebraic one. Equations, lot of equations. See here, plus to minus. So there is a potential drop V by X. And after traveling up here, I am traveling from negative to positive. So there is a rise in potential. So plus V angle 0. And I have traveled up to in this direction up to this branch. And after this, there is a decreasing potential. So minus R times I is equal to 0. And finally, I traveled the closed loop. See here. Already we got the expression for the current is 2V by R minus JXE. So we need to substitute the value of current in this equation. And then we need the expression for the V by X. If we substitute this value in this current, and if we do the calculation, we will get V by X is equal to V by X. The expression for the voltage V by X is equal to minus V times here R minus JXE. So therefore here will be R plus JXE. If you substitute the value of phi in this expression, and if you calculate the value of the V by X, finally you will get this expression. V by X is equal to minus V into R plus JXE by R minus JXE. So this is the expression. V by X is equal to minus V into R plus JXE by R minus JXE. But we need to write in a, this is a rectangular form, so we need to write it in a polar form. So the polar form is minus V. Minus V means it is in a, here right, minus V means here, minus V comma 0, means it is mod V angle minus 180, right? Or we can write plus 180 or minus 180. If we take in this anticlockwise, it is positive. If we take it in a clockwise, it is minus 180. So minus V, we can write it as a in polar form V angle plus 180. And this one, the magnitude of R plus jXe is equal to root over R square plus XE square. And the, this is the magnitude, and we need the angle part. Angle part is XE by R, right? So tan inverse XE by R. Similarly, if you write the expression in the polar form of the denominator part, the magnitude of this one is root over R square plus XE square. And this is the, if you write the angle part, this is minus tan inverse XE by R, right? See, the common part is this one, we cancel. The magnitude part cancel. The remaining terms are just V. See, the angle plus 180 and this one will get added. And if you go upper part, it will become again positive, right? So the net will be 180. This will become positive, and if it goes upper, it will become positive. Right? So plus plus will become 2, plus 2, plus 2 tan inverse, plus 2 tan inverse XE by R. So this is the expression we will get finally. So this is the expression for the V by X in polar form. In polar form, we got this expression. Now we need to draw for two different values. Say, let us get when R is equal to 0. So when R is equal to 0, this is the first case. Let me take this as the first case, right? First case. When R is equal to 0, V by X is equal to V. There is the V is independent of the resistance. So take it as same as V. See here. XE by 0, and R is 0. XE by 0 is, anything by 0 is infinity. So tan inverse infinity is 90. So 90 into 2, again it will become 180. So 180 plus 180, 360 degrees. So it will become 360 degrees. See here, in the second case, I will take R is equal to infinity. When R is equal to infinity, XE by infinity is 0. So tan inverse 0 is again 0 degree. So 2 into 0 degree is again 0 degree. So 180 degree plus 0 degree is equal to 180. So V by X is equal to V angle 180 degree. See, I will draw the graph of tan X. Tan X up to 90 degree and minus 90 degree. So this is 90 degree and it is minus 90 degree. See, the curve of tan X will be like this, right? This is the X, this is the tan X, right? So whenever X is 90 degree, the tan X will become infinity, positive infinity. Whenever the X is minus 90 degree, then the tan X will become minus infinity. See, as the degree goes on decreases, the tan X goes on decreases, right? As the X value decreases, the tan X value also decreases. See here R is increases. R is 0 and R is infinity means R is increasing from 0 to infinity. As R is increasing, XE by R goes on decreases. As R is increases, XE by R goes on decreases means the whole value goes on decreases means X value decreases. As X value decreases, for the tan X is also, see, as X value decreases, tan X value also decreases. So therefore, this whole value goes on decreases. So therefore, from 360, it is going to 180 degree. What I am trying to say is, when R is goes on increases, the angle goes on decreases from 360 degree to 180 means it can come up to, suppose let me consider one case 359 and another is 358, like it goes up to 180 degrees. So see here, now I am drawing the locus, right? I am drawing the locus of the V by X. This is the real part of V by X, and this is the imaginary part of V by X. See here, I am drawing the locus. This is the magnitude V, and this is a
This is a magnitude V and this is 360. 360 means when R is equal to 0, this is a V comma 0. 360 means in this way. So this is a point. This is a point when R is equal to 0. See, when R is equal to infinity, V by X is equal to V angle 180. V angle 180 means here. Minus V comma 0. Here plus V comma 0, this is minus V comma 0. This is a point. This is when R is equal to infinity. R is equal to infinity, right? See, R is increases from 0 to infinity. Therefore, 360 go, angle goes on decreases to 180. So, if it is when R is equal to 0, as R is increases, the angle goes on decreases. Means, the positive angle goes on decreases. Positive angle goes on decreases and finally it comes to this point. See, again I am telling, this is an angle, positive angle, right? This is the positive angle which I already considered. The clockwise is positive. So, as R is increases, the angle goes on decreases. As R is increases, see, this angle goes on decreases. This angle goes on decreases and finally it comes to 360. So, therefore, the locus is a semicircle. The same circle, and this point is 0 comma minus V, right? 0 comma minus V, and this length and each length is a V. Each that the radius of this semicircle is V and the diameter of this semicircle is 2V. This is the actual locus of this V by X, but in this option, they didn't give the same locus. They have given a shifted version. They have given a shifted version of this locus. So now, I will, in the options, they have given the locus as a shifted version. So now, I will draw the shifted version of this locus. Just see carefully. Just be patient and just see carefully. Now the answer will be very easy. See here. Same thing. See here, this is a locus, right? This is a locus which I got. Now let me assume this has 0 origin. Let me assume this has 0. Means the length is 2V, right? The diameter of this semicircle is 2V, right? So therefore this will become 2V comma 0. This is called 2V comma 0. This is the diameter, right? 2V comma 0. But from here, the radius is how much? The radius is V, right? The radius of this semicircle is V. So the radius is V. So this is actually they gave in the options of the gate question. After this question, they are given the option like this. So this point is 0, 0. This is 2V, 0. And this is the radius V. This is actual, when we assume this as 0, when this is origin, this is actual locus. If we shifted, if we take this point as origin, then this is the shifted locus of this one. But in options, they didn't give this option. So they gave only this option. So this is the final result. If you didn't understood this question, then again go back to the starting and please watch carefully. You will finally understand this one. By this lecture, we have successfully completed 50 numericals. And I am so much excited to teach you more numericals in the subject which completes the full gate network theory questions, previous year questions. If you like the content of this lecture, then please do like, share and subscribe our channel so that it gives motivation for us to do more this type of educational videos for the student community. If you like to tell any more improvement in this video lecture making and the content, then please do comment in the comment section and we will read each one comment and we will rectify ourselves to make better lecture videos for the student community. In this lockdown, stay home, stay safe and stay with your family and enjoy these days and also do the preparation simultaneously for the upcoming competitive examinations. Thank you so much for watching this video lecture.